Hey, this is Adrian Boysel. It's great to be here with you today. I wanted to share something with you that I feel is very important to get to know each other, to share a little bit about my history and who I am. It's very, very important I share that because I think it's gonna spark something in you and you're gonna see that I am just as good as you are and you have greatness inside of you. Just like Les Brown says, you truly have greatness inside of you. You were put here with a purpose and with a plan by whoever you want to give that glory to, whether it's God or the universe, but you have a purpose on this earth and you have a plan. And if you believe that with all of your heart, you will look at life from a different lens and from a different perspective, and you're going to get the chance to actually take action with the things that I'm going to teach you. And so when you hear my story and you hear where I come from, you're going to realize that I am no better than you and that you have every single opportunity available to you to make your life beyond what you could even imagine. But it's gonna start by taking action. As a kid, I grew up with a broken home at a very young age. My parents split when I was just a year old, and I didn't know my mom until I was 17 years old. I met my mom for the first time at 17. It was really hard growing up without a mom, but I had a grandmother who was a mom to me and really instilled a lot of values and principles and character in me that I still carry with me today. And so regardless of your background, how bad you've had it as a kid, because I'm sure there are plenty of people that are watching this video that have had it way worse than I have. And I had a hard upbringing. I had an abusive father. I had a non-available mother who wasn't there. But I had one person, my grandmother, who was always a constant in my life. And so I'm sure everybody in this video can relate that you all have somebody that you can look up to, somebody that was there for you, somebody that had your back. And that is very important, that there are some people out there, including me, that believe in you. Maybe you don't have anybody. Maybe you feel like you're alone in the world. Guess what? You're watching this video, you got me, okay? I got your back. Even if I don't know you, I'm gonna be there to support you. And so I grew up with a very broken home, very broken family, and with no opportunities that were handed to me. My family was broke, we didn't have any money. My dad was, I went to 12 different schools growing up as a kid. I had a very, very hard upbringing. I had to constantly be moving, constantly meeting new friends, constantly having to form new relationships. It was really hard to have stability in my life. And so a lot of you probably know what that's like, to have very little stability, but I had a deep passion inside of me from a very young age. I knew that I was put here for a reason, that I had a purpose and a plan, and it's a very strong part of who I am and who my being is. So if you go and look at your life, you know that you're put here for a reason. I know that you were put here for a reason. And so I went into school and I was told by teachers that I was never gonna cut it and that I was gonna struggle my whole life and I had learning disabilities and all these different things. Those are all limiting beliefs and things that people probably have put inside of your own mind and your own heart, and you're believing those things. And so what I want you to do today is I want you to let go of those things. I want you to give those to God, give those to whoever you feel like you need to give those, and let those go and have freedom. You deserve freedom in your life. You can't hold on to those things. I remember sitting at church with a guy who didn't even know me, and he knew that my childhood and my upbringing, however it came to him, that there was something inside of me, that I had these limiting beliefs that were holding on to me and that they needed to be released from me. So I want those to be released from you because you deserve better. You deserve all of your dreams and more, because there's more than you could probably even imagine, just like I can even imagine. I'm here at an amazing conference with celebrities and amazing people, people who are giving people, and you could be even further along than I am. So if you actually listen to that little voice inside of you and you believe in yourself, amazing things will happen. I went into high school and I started having friends tell me, man, you got a great voice, you should do radio. You got a great voice, you should do video production. And I honored the legacy of my grandfather who left an imprint on me as an entrepreneur and a business owner and a military veteran. He left an imprint on me, and that has carried me all throughout my career and been an inspiration for me. So if you don't have somebody that's inspiring you, you gotta go out there and find them. If you're an artist, if you're a musician, if you're a technical person and you're a numbers guy, if you're an engineer type person, there is somebody out there that will inspire you. Find inspiration, seek out the inspiration, because inspiration has been the thing that has kept my head above water, who has kept me going forward, kept my vision strong, and had my clarity. So I wanna share that with you. And regardless of your background and your upbringing, I made a lot of mistakes because of all the trauma and abuse and things that happened in my early childhood. There were some big things that happened in my early teen years, 18, 19 years old. I ended up spending 30 days in jail, and that was a turning point in my life where I looked at my life as a teenager from 16 being homeless all the way to 19 and looked at the things that I was doing and the ways that I was approaching life. You know, they say that if you throw the ball at the wall hard, it's gonna come back at you hard. And so I learned that throwing the ball a little softer and approaching life and not just going with the flow was gonna give me a much better life. And so when I ended up doing those 30 days locked up in jail, I had to take a hard look at myself and realize that I was making choices and making mistakes that I was paying for. I was sitting there locked away with no freedom, no rights. And it was I felt very small. But as I got out of there, I started surrounding myself with what I call titans. And these titans helped me transform my being, transform my mind, and helped me really realize that I was destined to more than that. So what I did is I actually wrote a business plan. My entire business plan I wrote in jail for my graphic design and printing business. And so I got out after 31 days and I implemented that business plan. And what I want you to take away from that is I took action. Action is almost everything. If you have the right mindset and you take massive action, you can get almost anywhere in life. There's really no limitations other than your mindset and the amount of action and the amount of work that you're able to put in. And that's been one of my secrets to my success, is that I'm willing to outwork my competition. I'm willing to work sometimes 24 hours straight just to make my dreams happen. If you believe in yourself that much, you'll do whatever it takes. A guy named Eric Thomas says, if you want to succeed as bad as you want to breathe, you will be successful. And it's so true. If you are willing to do whatever it takes to be successful and make the sacrifices, hanging out with friends, going to parties, doing all the things that are recreational, watching TV, if you're willing to put those things to the side and focus on building yourself, reading books, doing courses, doing coaching, and investing into yourself, there is literally no limits to how far you can go. Look at Elon Musk. Look at Jeff Bezos, look at the Tim Ferrisses of the world. The things, they're no different than you. They're no better than you, they're no better than me, but they went out there and they took action, they believed in themselves, and they had a clear vision of what they wanted to do, and they could just continue to move forward, and amazing things have happened. They're world-changing people, and you are a world-changing person. You have to believe that in your heart. I know that I'm a world-changing person. I know that through all of the journeys that I've made, all of the things, bad decisions, good decisions that I've made, that my life's purpose, and it just happened to me about a year and a half ago, the reason that I was put here on this earth, and this is probably gonna be part of the journey of this channel, is I was put here to help at-risk youth like myself. I was here to restore broken families, to help people that were lost, that didn't have anybody, that had their back, that need mentors. That's why I'm put here. I'm here to help the youth that have nobody that has their back. So I'm here to be your support system. I'm here to point you in the right direction. If you need help, there's no limitations to what you can do. So you just got to truly believe that in your heart and just go after it, man. You got to take some action and just go after it. Over the last decade, it's been a little bit more than a decade, about 13 years now, that I got out of jail from 2006, 2007 on to now. I mean, I've gone on to build multiple six-figure companies. I now have a seven-figure company that I'm building, which is a digital marketing agency. I have a team of people. I employ about 9 people currently. I provide for their families. I mean, I help provide roofs over their heads. People all over the country. I could never imagine, if you had told me this when I was sitting in a jail cell, that someday you'll have sold a company already and you'll have formed a seven-figure digital marketing agency, you'll be speaking on stages, you'll have had a radio show, you'll have had a podcast, you'll have interviewed with some of the greatest people and greatest minds of the world, like Jeff Hoffman and Tom Bilyeu. I mean, I've been on stages with some of the most incredible people, and even people that aren't celebrities, people that you would never expect, the person sitting on the other side of this camera, that are everyday heroes, that are out there chasing their dreams, making things happen for their family, and sharing their passion with the world. Maybe your calling isn't to be a celebrity. Maybe your calling is just to be the guy behind the camera that is helping people chase their dreams. I would not be recording this video if it wasn't for the guy sitting on the other side of this camera, Russo. So I gotta give it up to the people that are the silent heroes of the world. Not everybody wants to be in front of the spotlight. Maybe you're not an extrovert, maybe you're an introvert. But it doesn't mean that you can't write amazing copy, write content. You can't build amazing websites or do a blog or find ways to attribute your skills, your talents, your passion to the world. I'm telling you, you have to go out there, you have to do it. Otherwise, you're gonna live a life of regret. And when you get to the end of your life, whether you live a day, 10 more years, 100 years old, no matter what that is, you don't want to live a life that is unfulfilled, that you didn't reach what your calling was. Go after your calling, go after your mission. I am relentlessly pursuing my mission. There is nothing that's going to get in my way. My family still has to remain a top priority. It goes God, family, and work, but I know that my family is going to enable me to chase my dreams. My wife was the one that encouraged me. You gotta go out there and do this. This is a great opportunity. Look at the people that are going there, and you gotta have a little fun. So go rent the Corvette. I rented a Z06 Stingray Corvette for this event. if it was me and I was just gonna decide to do this myself, I would have rented like a $29 a day car and been economical and saved some money, but I wouldn't have had anywhere near as much fun. I wouldn't have been as vibrant as I am today, and I definitely wouldn't have been able to just have the experience that I've had. So I'm really opened up my mind and I changed my mindset that I deserve this. You deserve to have the life of your dreams. And maybe that is part of your limiting belief that you have, is you don't believe that you deserve to have an extraordinary life, because maybe you've made some mistakes. But guess what? Those mistakes don't define your future. Your future is defined by what you're going to do today in this moment and going forward. So, and you probably will make more mistakes. I'm gonna make mistakes tomorrow and going forward. I made mistakes yesterday. Those aren't gonna define your future. Just keep moving forward. You're gonna take some steps back, but you can make leaps forward and you can leave those mistakes behind, but you gotta learn from them. Make sure that you learn the mistakes. What I did recently, I started doing, is when I make a mistake that's like a big deal, I write it down and I dissect it, and I actually write a whole sheet on what the mistake was and how I could approach it differently in the future so that I don't impact the people that I love around me negatively, because some of these mistakes have very major consequences and you can't feel shame. So let go of the shame, let go of the guilt, just learn from them and just be humble and understanding that you're a human being, we live in a fallen world, and that nobody's perfect. You're gonna make mistakes along the journey, but again, they don't define you. What defines you is the action that you take, how you treat the people around you, and I actually came up with a quote the other day, love people like the way that you want to be loved. You wanna be loved, you wanna be cared for, you wanna be noticed, you want people to value you, then do the same for others. A lot of people are going out there and they're just making it about them. You need to be a giver. A fulfilled life comes from you giving to other people. When you give, you will be blown away by what you receive in return. I came here and talked to my video buddy here, Russo, and I was just willing to just give any information, any resources, and just shared my passion with him. And together, we've just had amazing synergy and what the future holds for both of us. I mean, from going to Costa Rica, who knows what's gonna happen? But the future and the potential is limitless. So go out there and make it happen. Live your dreams. Start taking action. Start changing your behaviors, because your behaviors, look at the behaviors and what you do on a daily basis. What time are you getting up every day? Who are you spending your time around? Who are you hanging out with? You know, they say, show me your friends and I'll show you your future. That could not be more true. The fact that I'm surrounding myself with the people that are here today is gonna define what my future looks like. And I'm gonna continue to surround myself with people like that on a day-to-day basis as much as I possibly can, because I know my future holds something great, and I know I have a big mission to fulfill of restoring broken families and helping at-risk youth, and there is nothing that is going to get in that way. Only God could get in the way, and he's not. He's the one that gave me the vision, and he knows what I have to do before I'm even gonna do it. So if you follow that journey, stay focused on your mission and on your path, and I know you'll get there. If you need help, don't hesitate to reach out to me. I'm a resource, I care about you, and I wanna see you successful, and I wanna see you live the life of your dreams. So God bless you guys. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video with me today. And as always, keep looking up.